Hi, today is Tuesday, June 27th, 2017, and this is A Swede Speaks. And I need to talk a little about, the debacle that's been going on between Kahin Ahmed and Rickard Jomshof, with Hanif Bali as kind of the third wheel. It's a funny story, or it's kind of funny, it's kind of absurd too, in many ways. But let's get started with what's been going on. Let's actually start with what happened in late 2016. On December 30th, 2016, the moderate politician Kahin Ahmed, who is originally Somali, but who is now a local politician in the Järva area in Stockholm, he wrote an article, an editorial, where he said that he was ashamed to be a part of the same party as Persian-born Hanif Bali, and that's because Hanif Bali had said some bad things about Muhammad and Islam. And Hanif Bali, as I said, he is born in Iran, he came to Sweden as a child, and he is a very staunch critic of Islam and of Muhammad, including calling Muhammad a pedophile, which, well, if, as Hanif Bali himself has written on Twitter several times, if you have another word for someone who has sex with a 9-year-old, or maybe she was a 12-year-old, while he himself was in his 50s, please give me that word. Because as long as I don't get another word that will correctly describe what was going on, pedophile seems to be the best word to describe the so-called Prophet Muhammad. And because of this and statements like these, this Kahin Ahmed wrote the article in which he said that he was ashamed to be part of the same party as Hanif Bali. Hanif Bali is, by the way, a member of parliament for the moderate party, which is good. He's one of the few good ones in parliament for that party. He has been fired from some things that he was doing for the moderate party because they thought he was too much anti-Islam. So now let's fast forward a few months until almost 6 months. They were going to have the Politicians' Week in Järva in the north of Stockholm. And Järva is the area where Tensta and Rinkeby is. And I guess you've heard of Rinkeby. And they had the Politicians' Week where politicians from different parties would come and talk and present their ideas and try to gain support from the locals living there. And among these parties invited was the Sweden Democrats. So Kahin Ahmed wrote a new article where he wrote that Jimmy Åkesson, the leader for the Sweden Democrats, isn't welcome in the suburbs. Because the Sweden Democrats, according to Kahin Ahmed, is a party with Nazi roots. Well, there were a few people when they started the Sweden Democrats who were Nazis, that's correct. And I am not very fond of the Sweden Democrats, but that's got nothing to do with that. It's got to do with, I think, they are way too left-wing on economic issues, and they don't understand why Christianity is necessary to defend Swedish culture, because Swedish culture is basically the Swedish kind of Judeo-Christian Western culture, with, of course, some old heathen Swedish roots mixed into it, but they often don't. But that's not his criticism of the Sweden Democrats, that's my criticism of them. So, never mind that. The point here is that Kahin Ahmed, who is a local politician for the moderate party, why does the moderate party keep on inviting these kind of people into their party? A few years ago, they had an Islamist from Gothenburg named Vaberi in parliament. He was even running an Islamist school back in Gothenburg while he was a member of parliament. They do this crazy stuff because they want the immigrant vote, or they want the Muslim vote, and they are not the only party doing this. But anyway, so this local politician tells an elected member of parliament that he is not welcome there. He got there anyway, by the way. But this infuriated the party secretary.
Den moderata politikern
kan... Yeah, sorry about that. This infuriated the party secretary of the Sweden Democrat, a man named Rickard Jomshof. So he answered this by stating on Twitter to Kahin Ahmed, "You are not welcome in Sweden." And of course, this made, well, all hell break loose, to put it that way. And they say that Richard Jomshof is a racist and he shows the true nature of the Sweden Democrats and stuff like that. And of course, Jomshof has now said he's sorry. Maybe he wrote in effect and he shouldn't have written that, and so on. Well, okay. But the thing is this. I agree with Mr. Jomshof's original statement. And this is not because of the color of Kahin Ahmed's skin. I couldn't care less if he is black or white or yellow or whatever. I don't care. What I care about is that Ahmed is obviously an Islamist. And Islam does not belong in the West. Period. It doesn't belong in the West. And the problem with Sweden is the cultural relativism. The ideological and cultural relativism saying that all ideas are equally good, all cultures are equally good, all religions are equally good, but they're not. Trust me on this, they are not. And if you really don't know, ask a Christian from Lebanon, or a Syriac Christian, or a Jew from Lebanon, or anyone who is non-Muslim from a Muslim-majority country. So Jomshof is right. Ahmed shouldn't be welcome in Sweden. Of course, it's a little late now. He's a Swedish citizen and all that. But Jomshof is right. These values are incompatible with Swedish and Western culture, and they don't belong here. So my sympathies are with Jomshof, but he should have stood by his original statement. He could have clarified, I don't know, but I suppose that Jomshof's problem was Ahmed's values, not the color of his skin. I am pretty sure of that, but I don't know. But I mean, I am a friend of a friend of a friend of Jomshof, so from what I know, he is not a racist, but of course I could be wrong. But he should have stood by that and said that instead. So that's what I'm saying. Kahin Ahmed, you are not welcome in Sweden, you are not welcome in Norway, you are not welcome in the West, and you should go home to Somalia. Seriously, and what we should do, we should stop all Islamic immigration, and we should do it now. And that's what I have to say about this right now. I would like to thank the people who are supporting this channel through Patreon, through PayPal, through prayers. That's all greatly appreciated. And there are tiers, or is it tiers? Someone's gonna have to teach me how to pronounce that word. For patrons and donors, and for information about that, look in the box below. And if you like this channel, please subscribe so you don't miss anything. If you agree, if you disagree, comment below. Please share my videos on social media, on Facebook and Twitter and other social media that allows you to share. And if you like this video, please like it. And of course, I would also like to encourage you to support this channel. And I will include all the necessary information in the information box below. This is a Swede Speaks. Have a nice day.